Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. This is Ashok from TechieBee and today we have another ROM for MIA1 which is known as Resurrection Remix. Let's take a look on this ROM without wasting any time. First, going to the settings, about phone, and here you can see this software information. Model is MIA1, Android version is 8.1 with a security patch that is 5th March 2018. This has the latest security patch as of now. And if you guys are not aware, Resurrection Remix is one of the ROM which is highly customizable and you can customize the device as per your requirement. Installation process on this ROM is not like previous ROMs. So I'll mention one video in the description below. You can install TWRP recovery using that video and flash this ROM. If you have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. I'll make a separate video. So this will be the first look of your ROM. Long pressing home screen will take you to launcher setting. Here you can customize the launcher. Not much of changes are done as it's based on Lineage OS 15.1. In this video, I'll be showing you what are the features available and things which are not working on this. I'll also show you the benchmark results. We'll compare it with the Lineage OS. To install this ROM, you can refer a video which is given in the description below. That will help you out in installing TWRP on your device, and that's a permanent method of installing TWRP recovery, which will avoid you always downgrading to Android Nougat before installing any custom ROM. So guys, this ROM has tons of features which can be found under settings. Under configuration, you can find customizations related to status bar, panels, quick settings, recents, interface, lock screen, buttons, navigation, animations, gestures, and miscellaneous. So we won't be covering all of these because I have been covering all these customizations in almost all the rooms. We'll take a look on few of the features. So guys, first of all, as you can see, it is completely similar to Lineage OS. This ROM comes pre-installed with audio effects, FM radio application, wallpaper application, which is a Google wallpaper application. Under display, you can go to advanced and find ambient display option. This is working fine, but the option below ambient display, that is tap to wake, is not working. So once you on this also and lock the screen, double tap to wake does not work on this ROM. So this is the first thing which is not working. Under settings, you can find only one option, that is gestures, which says jump to camera. But camera is not working, but this option is still working. Now let's go to the settings and take a look on the main customization options available. So under status bar, you get clock and date, which can be changed from left, right, centered, and you can also hide the clock which is available on the status bar. You get option to change the font style. If you want to keep it big, you can keep it big, or else you can keep it small as per your requirement. Under battery, you have lots of options to customize. You can change this icon style of the battery, and battery bar can also be adjusted on the status bar. And right now it is not visible because color what we have chosen is black. So let's change the color, and here you can see now a battery bar is available. And if you enable blend colors, this will change color automatically as per the battery charged. Here you have option of few colors, which says full, empty, red, green. You can choose any of these. Later going to brand logo, which is just a Resurrection logo, can be found from here, and you can enable it on status bar. Status bar gestures, that is brightness control. If you enable this, you just have to tap on the status bar and you can increase or decrease the brightness by sliding on the status bar. Then double tap to sleep on status bar is working, which was previously working on Lineage OS also. Then moving on to panels, here you get options of volume panel, power menu, and few notification options. Going to recents, here you have few options and you can also choose alternative recents, which is known as slim recents. Under alternative recents, you can enable slim recents, and if you tap recent button, here you can see the recents has been changed. Going to interface, here you have fingerprint settings. We'll check out whether fingerprints are working or not. But in this, you have option of fingerprint authentication vibration. Fingerprint unlock, you can unlock your device after the reboot just using your fingerprint. After that, you have personalizations, display size, custom LCD, density pixel can be changed. Head up notifications can be enabled from here, and you can also add the apps which you don't want in the head up notification. You also get theme option, under which you can change the style of your theme. So here you have one is the automatic, which can be set as per the wallpaper you have. After that it comes up automatic according to date and time, light and dark if you want. You get few accent colors available here which can be changed from this option. Under interface you also get screenshot option. You can choose a screenshot type. Here you have two options. One is the take full screenshot and the next one is you can just select the area of the screenshot. Let's take a screenshot first using volume down and power key together. And now choose the area which you wanted to keep it in the screenshot. You can choose any area that will be taken as a screenshot. Going to gesture anywhere, if you enable this, you will get a windows at the corner of your screen which can be changed. You can change the position from left to right, and if you just tap on this you can draw a custom gestures here. You can save them first and use them later to launch any application. App circle bar gives you an option to have all the apps on one bar, which will help you very easily to locate different applications from one screen. Under miscellaneous, it gives you few options of suspended actions, weather and IME settings. Then last one is the about, where you get all the information about the ROM. Now talking about things like camera. So camera, this is a thing which is not working. If you open camera, you get an error, and if you install any third party application also, the camera does not work. And under display, one more thing which is not working is the live display. So you cannot enable from here. If you want, you can just give a try. None of the settings are getting changed, so live display is not working. Rest other than that, vault services are working, fingerprint services are also working fine, no issues in fingerprint scanner.
Talking about benchmark results, we have taken benchmark results using Geekbench application 4 and Antutu Bench application. Under Geekbench applications, results were single core score 850 and multi core score 4183. Towards your right hand side, you can see those were taken on Lineage OS 15.1. Now going with Antutu Bench application, under this scores were 80,204, and towards your right hand side, those are from Lineage OS 15.1.
So guys, as of now only this much in this video. If you have any kind of questions related to installation or any other stuff, do let me know in the comment section below. Hope you like this video. If you like the video, do give me a thumbs up, and also if you are new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.